Okay, now we're back in the office of Avis. Avis, how did Ellenwood get started here? It's kind of a unique story. It's like a little history to it.
Exactly. We started Ellenwood All-Stars in the year 2000. Before that, I started coaching the recreation team. Glenwood Hills kind of got thrown into coaching. Back when I was a cheerleader, we had basic cheerleading, you know, a medium, a middle school, high school, and not to the level of all-star cheerleading that we do now. But anyway, Glenwood Hills is where I started coaching my daughter's team at age four. And the kids just kind of coached them every year until they actually went through a 120-pound competition. Mm-hmm. Of course, the picture you see here is Glenwood Hills and the teams. We started back in 2000. I was coaching since 1995 in recreation.
Okay.
So the team you see on the wall, I want to make sure I remind myself of every day of how we got started in All-Stars. And the kids, I started tryouts for just one competitive team, and we ended up having three competitive teams in the beginning. The parents asked me to start an All-Star competitive team, and we grew from there. So started out doing cheerleading part-time, and end up now this is what I do full-time. And I worked for Corporate America, Novartis Ophthalmics, for 15 years. And from that point, I was laid off, and I invested all my retirement, everything in okay, you didn't get that, did you?
No, that's fine.
Invested all my retirement and all of my savings into competitive cheerleading. And my husband actually gave me the idea of starting a competitive program. And I had no idea it was going to grow to the point of having over 200 cheerleaders in competitive cheerleading, and not counting the kids that we have in classes, non-competitive, as well as the kids that we have in our after-school program and summer camp.
Oh, now, when you guys first started out in the rec program, obviously success wasn't immediate. I mean, this was a whole new venture for you. I mean, as far as from a cheerleading standpoint, not necessarily a business standpoint, but a cheer standpoint. Explain some of the differences, like we were discussing earlier, as far as what was with the rec, and then you're like the competitive one. I mean, wow, this is a little bit different.
Right. Now, for recreation cheerleading, we started in competitive cheerleading at a recreation level, in competitive cheerleading.
Gotcha.
There's recreation, which will only do one competition that we started out at, with recreation competing at several events, up to, you know, 5-6 events a year. And then, of course, we worked our way up to all-star cheerleading from recreation cheerleading in our program. So the first 5 years was really a learning experience for me to learn the industry in all-star cheerleading. It's not like you just jump into it and you're in all-stars. You have to learn the industry and what it's all about, and what the industry is looking for when you actually attend a competition.
Mm-hmm.
So we started out the first 5 years as a learning experience for the program. And take a lot of volunteers from parents, staff members. Of course, you can't pay anybody when you first start.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, now we're up to being able to pay our staff, our coaches, and be able to pay our rent, mm-hmm. and all the overhead here, finances here at the gym.
Right.
It's a full-time job. I mean, if you really want to do a good job at competitive cheerleading, it's a full-time job. It takes more than just competitive cheerleading. It, you know, it's teaching kids responsibility, the goals that they set, their goals as to what they want in the future, time management,
mm-hmm.
As well as communication and being in team bonding.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all-stars. It's all part of all of that.
Right, right. Now, as far as like the skill development that it took to when you initially started out as a rec and then went to all-star, I mean, there had to be, you know, different. I mean, you almost had to, you know, to start learning a whole different way of training them and getting them ready for that type of competition. Can you kind of go into that a little bit?
Of course. We have outsourced most of our training as far as choreography.
Mm-hmm.
We have, and I also have in-house choreographers that teach our routines here in the house. But it takes, you know, getting the best training possible from the coaches, as well as the outsourcing the choreography routines. And in-house teaching tumbling and technique is really big in all-stars. You have to have a whole package.
Mm-hmm.
And that, with that, there's cost, you know, having to bring in outsource staff to come in and do that for us. But the most of it is taught here in the gym as far as the technique, tumbling, transitions and all of that, and then we have someone come in to teach the routines.
Right. Now, since I've been here, all day, you have an incredible group of people that work for you. I mean, that have been here since day one. I mean,
yes. This
is kind of like a big family here, more or less.
That's correct. And once again, we can't do it alone. This takes everybody. I have to have everybody in place and dependable staff and volunteers. From the front office, business office, they have to know their job and take care of the business part of it. Parents want to volunteer and help out with attendance and practices and whatever we need here at the gym. The parents have to be on board. They want to volunteer and and help the gym as far as being team moms, team parents, make sure their teams have what they need for the season. It takes a whole package from everybody in order to make this program successful.
Right. Now, 14 years in the business, since you first started, what are some immediate things that come to mind as far as looking back on those years and saying, wow, it's, you know, this is where we started, this is where we are now, this is where we're wanting to go. What are some of the immediate things that come to mind where, you know what, I'm really proud of that, I'm really proud of this, or how the kids have responded to this? What's some immediate things?
The immediate things is being able to compete with the best. Looking back when we first started and growing up to where we are now, is that we're able to compete with on any level of our competitors and with some of the biggest programs it is and be successful at it. Mm-hmm. Our kids can hold their own, and that's, you know, each year is a progress. I can see progress each year for all of our teams and our programs.
That's great. I mean, it also seems to me like one of the things that you guys really pride yourself on is teaching life skills to these kids. I mean, since exactly. I've been here, I mean, you've been on top of it with time management, with hard work, and keeping the kids accountable. Kind of go in some different areas of how you try to develop, I guess, the total person or the total athlete or the total kid.
Well, starting out at tryouts, once tryouts is completed and the parents have a parent meetings, the kids that make the teams, everybody make a team. However, some teams, kids may be on prep team, meaning that's a beginning team to get them started and all-stars. But for the most part, our first day of practice with their coaches, we meet with each team, and coaches let them know the expectations of what's expected of them from day one. Mm-hmm. And from that point, those coaches, they have to instill in the kids as to what's expected, and that's every day. Hard work, dedication, and loving what you do. In order to do competitive cheerleading, you have to love what you do. It's a really hard sport. It's not easy at all. You have to really enjoy what you do. So we start there from day one as teaching the guidelines and rules of a gym.
Good. Very good. We appreciate your time.
All right. Thank you. Thanks for having us.